The stage play of Hamlet is a work of literature that has often been associated with Shakespeare, but more and more evidence is coming to light that makes it seem less likely that Shakespeare is the actual writer of Hamlet. To understand the debate for Hamlet's true author, you must look at three components: the story of Hamlet, the reasons why Edward De Vere, the 17th Earl of Oxford, could have been the author, and reasons why Shakespeare has been considered the author for so long.
The tragedy of Hamlet, often shortened to just Hamlet, is one of Shakespeare's most famous tragedies. Hamlet's father has been murdered by Hamlet's uncle, Claudius, and married Hamlet's mother, Gertrude. Because King Hamlet is dead, Claudius has become the king of Denmark. The play begins with Hamlet and his friend Horatio seeing the ghost of King Hamlet. Hamlet once again sees his father's ghost, and he tells his son that he has been murdered by Claudius. Hamlet vows to revenge his father. He decides to pretend to be crazy to investigate the situation.
Hamlet begins to act crazy and rejects his girlfriend Ophelia while her father, Polonius, and Claudius are spying on him. Claudius tells Hamlet's friends Rosencrantz and Guildenstern to figure out what's going on with Hamlet. A group of traveling actors arrives, and Hamlet works with them to create a play that resembles what happened to his father to present to the king and queen.
You shall see anon how the murderer gets the love of Gonzago's wife.
How fares my lord?
At the performance, Hamlet watches Claudius very closely to see how he reacts. Claudius gets flustered and storms out during the performance. Hamlet is summoned by his mother, and on the way, he finds Claudius praying and debates whether or not to kill him. He decides not to, because if he were to kill him while he is praying, he'd be sent to heaven. Polonius decides to hide in Gertrude's room to protect her from her unpredictable son. When Hamlet arrives to talk with his mother, he hears a rustling in the curtains and stabs it, ending up killing Polonius, thinking it was Claudius. The ghost reappears and tells his son not to delay revenge or upset his mother.
Claudius plans to kill Hamlet by sending him to England. Hamlet learns of this plan once he arrives. He returns to Denmark and sends his friends Rosencrantz and Guildenstern to their deaths instead. Having been rejected by Hamlet, Ophelia is devastated over the loss of her father and kills herself.
At Ophelia's funeral, Hamlet confronts Ophelia's brother Laertes and they get into a fight. A duel is arranged so that Hamlet and Laertes can fight it out. Claudius conspires with Laertes to kill Hamlet during the duel. Hamlet will either die by getting stabbed with a poisoned rapier or by drinking poisoned celebratory wine. Seeing that Hamlet is winning, Gertrude drinks some of the wine and dies. Hamlet and Laertes are both stabbed by the poisoned rapier and Laertes dies. While dying, Hamlet kills Claudius and tells Horatio to tell his story.
Now knowing the storyline of Hamlet, you can begin to see why it is thought that Edward De Vere wrote Hamlet. Hamlet can be viewed as sort of an autobiography of Oxford's life. Many of the characters in Hamlet are very similar to those in De Vere's life.
The first character comparison is the Earl of Sussex in King Hamlet. Oxford's biological father died when he was young, and the Earl of Sussex served as a father figure for him. Sussex was the one who encouraged Oxford to present his plays in court. Throughout his life, Sussex was harassed by the Earl of Leicester, who was thought to be the model for Claudius. Sussex died suddenly, but there's no direct correlation between the Earl of Leicester and his death, although Leicester was known for his knowledge of poisons. This seems to be very similar to King Hamlet being killed by poison orchestrated by Claudius. It is also thought that Sir William Cecil was the real-life model for Polonius. Sir William Cecil served as a legal guardian for boys of nobility whose fathers died before they were of age. When Oxford's father died, he was sent to live at the Cecil house. In the first quarto version of Hamlet, Polonius was named Corambus, which mocks Cecile's motto, Cor Unum Vi Unum, which means one heart, one way. Cecil frequently boasted as a good Protestant that he had been born during the Diet of Worms, which was when Martin Luther opposed the ideas of the Catholic Church. After Hamlet kills Polonius, Claudius asks, "Where's Polonius?" And Hamlet replies, "A certain convocation of political worms are eaten at him. your worm is your only emperor for diet. There seems to be too much of a correlation for this just to be coincidence.
Cecile's daughter, Anne Cecile, was married to Oxford and is thought to be the inspiration for Ophelia. Their marriage allowed William Cecile to gain many benefits, including alliances. Interestingly, though, Ophelia means a help, a gain of resource, in Greek. Similarly to the relationship between Ophelia and Hamlet, Oxford and Anne's relationship was not a good one. Anne was treated very brutally by Oxford. Oxford even refused to see Anne for a 5-year period of time when he suspected her of infidelity.
Another connection to Hamlet was Oxford's cousin named Horatio. De Vere and Horatio were very close, just like Hamlet was very close to his best friend Horatio.
Many of the events that happened in Hamlet seem to directly correlate to the events that happened in Oxford's life. A big part of Hamlet is all the deaths that occur. In fact, the play ends with almost everyone dying. In Oxford's maturity, he killed an undercook named Thomas Brecknell at the Cecil House. Oxford was practicing fencing with live blades when Thomas Brecknell was stabbed in the leg and bled out.
In Oxford's surviving letters to his mother, there is not much warmth towards her. An obsession with fickleness of women is evident not only in Shakespeare's plays, but also in early poems associated with De Vere. Hamlet is one of few Shakespeare plays that includes a mother-son relationship. The relationship presented in Hamlet is not the strongest one. This relationship could apply to his relationship with his actual mother, or his relationship with Queen Elizabeth, who he was quite close to until they had a falling out.
Oxford's status also plays a part in why some people consider him the writer of Hamlet. It seems that Hamlet had to be written by someone of higher birth. The Search of an Eternal Norm says that the character of Hamlet suggests that Hamlet was written by someone of higher birth because the character is profoundly maladjusted, he is in rebellion against the requirements of his birth and station, and he sought an escape.
The play's setting employs information that was directly available to Oxford, but not everyone else. Oxford's brother-in-law, Lord Willoughby, was sent as an emissary to the court of Denmark at Elsinore in 1583. Willoughby's eyewitness accounts about the castle and the Danish customs like cannon. This refers to the Danish custom to shoot a cannon when a king made a toast. The Great Hall in Kronborg had tapestries displaying Danish kings, something Willoughby could have told De Vere. When Hamlet tells Gertrude to compare the two brothers' portraits, he is actually referring to the one that hung in Elsinore.
The author knew things about Cecil and his family that only could be known by a member of his household, which Oxford would have known, having the connection to Anne and William. Polonius's advice to Laertes echoes what Cecil wrote for his son when he set off for Paris. Dr. Lewis Wright, the former director of the Folger Shakespeare Library, has acknowledged the unlikelihood of any commoner having seen this private manuscript. Historians, however, still have several reasons to believe that Shakespeare is the true writer of Hamlet. Shakespeare had a son named Hamnet who died at the age of 11 in 1596. Many people think that the play Hamlet was a way to honor his dead son.
Hamlet can be considered one of Shakespeare's greatest tragedies. We can't be 100% sure who actually wrote Hamlet, but there is evidence that sway many people one way or the other. There are so many connections between the plot of Hamlet and the life of Edward De Vere, but there is also evidence that points that Shakespeare is the author. One day we will hopefully know who is the true author of Hamlet, but until then we must use the evidence given to us to draw our own conclusions.